Myself, Dr. Rajeshwari, Associate Professor, Plant Pathology, working at Cochrane Research Station, Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, Aliyar Nagar. Here, I am going to deliver a lecture on integrated pest and disease management in coconut. So, as we all know, coconut is an important plantation crops in India. It is called as Kalpaka Vriksha or Tree of Heaven or Tree of Abundance, because each and every part of the coconut is useful to human being. The coconut palm is globally cultivated in around 93 countries. In India, it is grown in 2.1 million hectares with the production of 14,075 millionaires, with an average productivity of 6,702 nuts per hectare per year. Coconut palming provides livelihood security to millions of people across India, and it also provides improved nutrition, employment and income generation. Though coconut palm is a hardy crop, it is affected by many pests and diseases. So, important pests which infest coconut are rhinoceros beetle, red palm weevil, black-headed caterpillar, eriophyt mite, white grub, and rugose spiraling whitefly. So, rhinoceros beetle is scientifically known as Orectus rhinoceros. It is distributed all over coconut growing regions of Asia. So, it also infects oil palm, date palm, and palmyra. So, coming to the damage symptom caused by rhinoceros beetle, so adult beetle cut and chew the tender and open leaves and inflorescence. So, on the affected leaves, on emergence, give V-shaped appearance. The infected leaves also shows infected leaves also shows crinkling. On the affected portions, we can see the chewed tissues as a fiber. It also provides entry point for red palm weevil and other pathogens. So, this is the symptoms caused by rhinoceros beetle. So, on the newly emerged leaves shows V-shaped cuttings, and also leaf shows crinkling. So, we can see the chewed fibers on the infested part. So, coming to the life cycle of rhinoceros beetle, as I already told you, this here the adult beetle is the damaging stage of the pest. So the adult beetle lay 40 to 60 eggs in the manure pit. From the eggs, within 10 days the grubs catches out and it's lost for 4 to 5 months. So after 4 to 5 months it develops into a pupae. From the pupae, within 25 to 30 days the adults will emerges. So the lifespan of the adult is 5 months. So, coming to the integrated disease management strategy for rhinoceros beetle. So, all the dead palms in the coconut garden should be removed because it serves as a breeding ground for rhinoceros beetle. So, the various stages, larvae, pupae are collected from the manure pit and it should be destroyed. So, the ground should be absorbed at every harvest, and the adults should be collected with the help of cook, and it should be killed. Light trap should be set up to attract and kill the adult beetles. So naphthalene ball should be placed at the rate of 3 per palm, and also ground application of neem seed kernel powder plus sand at the ratio of 1:2. So it should be kept at the rate of 150 gram per palm to the base of the 3 innermost leaves. So, for attracting the adults, mud pots containing castor cake 2.5 kg plus yeast 5 gram, acetic acid 5 ml, pieces of coconut petiole grains, it should be placed at 30 per acre, and also application of green muscardine fungus, it is metallizing encephaly at the rate of 0.10 to 10 to the power 11 spores per meter cube, or spraying of metallizing culture, it is 250 ml, should be mixed to 750 ml. And it should be sprayed in the manure pit to check the perpetuation of the pest. So, release of baculovirus infected beetles at the rate of 15 per hectare during evening hours. The rhino trap should be set up at the rate of 1 per acre to kill the adults. So, this photograph shows the rhino loop traps placed to attract the and kill the adults beetle. So, coming to the red palm weevil, it is scientifically known as Incoporus ferruginus. So, it affects palms of 8 years old. So here the other beetles lay eggs in the soft tissues and injured portions. From the egg, the grubs emerges out. It makes tunnel into the stem and feeds on the tender tissues inside the form. So it remains hidden inside the form and its complete life cycle, and finally kills the form if infestation is unnoticed. So the main important damaging symptoms are yellowing and wilting of the middle whole leaves, and also it makes small holes on the form, and from that reddish brown liquid oozes out. So we can also see longitudinal splitting of base of the base, and also the cocoon is present. We can see these chewed up fibers at the base of the affected form. So the beetle also make gnawing sound from the infested trunk. Shallow planting, injuries to the top tissue due to the mechanical cultivation, bud rot, leaf rot, infection, and infestation by rhinoceros beetle are the major source of entry. So these are the damaging, it is yellowing, wilting. So chewed fibers are seen. We can see the small holes on the base of the trunk. From that, oozing out of reddish brown liquid. This is the adult beetle. So coming to the life cycle of red form weevil. So adult beetle lays 300 eggs on the soft tissues. From the eggs, within 3 days, the grubs emerges out, and the lifespan of the grubs lasts for 55 to 60 days. So after that, it become pupae. From the pupae, within 25 days, the adult emerges out. So coming to the integrated management strategies. So proper sanitation should be maintained with periodical cleaning. So the dead form should be removed then and then to prevent the perpetuation of pest. So injuries to the stem or trunk should be avoided, to which serves the oviposition sites for the weevil. So if there is any hole, it should be filled with cement, and also the mixture of sand and neem seed powder should be applied once in 3 months to prevent the attack of rhinoceros beetle damage. So naphthalene balls also should be placed 3 per form. So root feeding should be given with azadirachtin 5%. It is 10 ml of azadirachtin plus 10 ml of water. It should be given for 3 times at 45 days interval. So for attracting adult beetles, so mud pots containing sugarcane molasses at the rate of 2.5 kg plus yeast 5 gram, mastic acid primer with pieces of coconut fronds. So these pots should be placed 30 per acre to attract and kill the adult red form weevil. Ferroleo trap with food attractant may also kept at the rate of 1 per hectare. So third important pest is black-headed caterpillar. Here the damaging stage is larvae. So this larvae feeds on the under surface of the leaves, resulting in considerable reduction in photosynthetic area. So we can see the presence of galleries on the lower surface of the leaf with leaf or dead stages of the pest. So infested fronds give burned up appearance. So these are all the damaging symptoms of black-headed caterpillar. We can see the burned up appearance, and also under surface of the leaf showing the galleries. So coming to the life cycle of black-headed caterpillar, here the moth, this adult moth lays 135 to 145 eggs on the under surface of the leaf. Within 3 days, this egg catches out and larvae emerges. This larvae feeds on the under surface of the leaf for 30 to 35 days. Then it becomes pupae. From the pupae, within 8 to 10 days, the moth will emerges. So the coming to the management strategy. So the severely infected lowermost leaf should be removed, and also light trap should be set up at the rate of 7 per hectare, and also spraying of azadirachtin at the rate of 3 ml. It should be mixed with 1 ml of sandowit and spray on the affected leaves. Root feeding also should be recommended with asarjakin. Suggest 10 ml of asarjakin is mixed with 10 ml of water. So release of Brecon, Previcorni, Pacitoid is also recommended at the rate of 30 per pound. So coming to the fourth important pest, Eriophyte mite. So this Eriophyte mite mainly infects buttons of 2 to 6 months old. So it feeds on the mesenchymatic tissues and multiply under the perion. So that this infestation results in shedding of buttons. So on acute stage, there will be appearance of longitudinal fissures on the button. So we can see the exudation of gummy fluid from the fissures and also formation of shriveled nut. So this causes yield loss up to 25 to 30%. So coming to the management strategy, so when comparing other varieties, Kendali dwarf was found to be tolerant to Eriophyte mite. So here we can manage this Eriophyte mite infestation by applying balanced fertilizers, that is Formian manure 50 kg per pound, urea 1.3 kg, super phosphate 2 kg, potash 3.5 kg, neem cake 5 kg, gypsum 1 kg, magnesium sulfate 0.5 kg, and borax 50 kg. If you apply these quantum of fertilizers, then we can manage this Eriophyte mite infestation. And also green manure and green lily manure crop like danger, sandam, and calopeconium and theraria were raised around the tree trunk and it should be plowed in situ. And also spot application of asaridactin 1% at the rate of 5 ml plus 1 ml of sandalwood, or neem oil 3% at the rate of 3 ml in 1 liter of water along with 1 ml of sandalwood is recommended for managing this Eriophyte mite. So coming to the fifth most important pest, that is white grub, Leucocrylus conifera. So this pest is confined to sandy loam soil. Here the grub is the damaging stage. Grubs feed on the roots of coconut and several intercrops like cassava, yams and banana, and cocoa, which are cultivated as an intercrop in coconut. So coming to the life cycle, so egg stage is 23 days, the larval period is last up to 260 days, and pupal period is for 25 days, and the longitude adult is 50 days. So here these pests infest both nursery as well as older coconut plantation. In the nursery, the grubs feed on the tender roots and also tunnel into the bowl and collar regions, resulting in drying of spindle leaves and gradual death of the seedlings. In older coconut plantation, so continuous infestation results in yellowing of leaves, premature nut fall, delayed flowering, retardation of growth, and tapering of ground, reduction in yield. So these pests can be managed by recommending deep plowing during pre and post monsoon periods for exposing crops to predators. So these pests should be collected mechanically and destroyed. And light trap should be set up at the rate of 1 per hectare. So borate or thimet is supplied at the rate of 10 per pound during monsoon period. And also soil drenching with chlorpyrifos at the rate of 7 ml is recommended per pound during June-September. So coming to the other pest, that is rugo smiling white fly. This RSW, so Aliroides rugoperculatus. So here this RSW was initially recorded as South America. So this RSW infestation was observed in Pollachi, Tamil Nadu during 2016. So here the colonies of rugo spiling whitefly with immature stages suck the sap from the undersurface of the coconut leaflets by pointed stylus, and the pupa are found encrusted on the leaf. So because of continuous feeding, sweet honeydew is secreted in huge quantity which drip downwards. So this attract when fungus corners capnodium, which form a black incrustation on the infected leaves. So on the affected surface of the plants, the photosynthetic ability is greatly reduced. This pest does not kill the plant, but it interfered with the normal growth of the host. So, because these lay eggs on swirling form, that is why it is known as rugose, that is swirling white fly. So, these are all the nymphs of swirling white fly. So, adult, so the shooting mold infested rounds. So, for controlling these pests, so yellow sticky trap is recommended at the rate of 10 per acre to monitor rugose swirling white fly population. Water should be sprayed forcibly on the undersurface of the leaf. So maida flour should be sprayed at the rate of 25 gram per liter to plague off shooting mold. So the chrysophylla should be released at the rate of 1000 eggs per hectare, and also stapling of leaflets containing Encasia parasitoid cocoons on the infested leaflets. So this is a light drop or attracting rugose swirling white fly. So yellow sticky traps for attracting rugose swirling white fly. This photograph shows water spray. So coming to the diseases of coconut. So important diseases which impacts coconut rot: buttrot, basal stem rot, stem bleeding, leaf blight, daily spot, kala wilt or root wilt, and leaf rot diseases. So coming to the buttrot, which is caused by a fungus known as Phytophthora palmivora. This disease is otherwise known as Magalli disease. This disease is more severe in young forms up to 10 years. So here we can see the brown discoloration of a hot leaf followed by drooping of leaves. The entire base of the ground rotten and emit foul smell. So on the infected portion we can see the white fungal coating. Second infestation by larvae is also observed. If we pull out the central shoot, it come out easily. So leaf falling and bud shedding is common. And also severe infection leads to complete shedding of leaves, finally death of the form. So these are the symptoms of buttrot. It is brown discoloration on cut leaf, rotting of central shoot, and also we can see the white fungal coating and the infected portion. Second infection by larvae in grown-up plants which infected by buttrot. So for managing the disease, so the young forms are observed regularly for the incidence of disease. If the palms are infected, the ground should be cleaned and applied with 1% boron mixture or 0.25% copper oxychloride. So application of 100 gram each of Pseudomonas fluorescens and Trichomycin along with 10 kg of formian manure. It should be applied once in 6 months. And also preparated sachet containing porate or naphthalene balls or neem seed kernel powder at the rate of 5 gram per packet should be placed to get rid of red form weevil infestation. So coming to the basal stem rot disease, which is otherwise known as Thanjavur disease, which is also also caused by a fungus known as Ganoderma lucidum, and another species Ganoderma oplanatum also causes the basal stem rot. Since this disease was first recorded in Thanjavur district, so it is known as Thanjavur disease. So this disease infects the palms of 10 to 30 years old. So the infected palm shows yellowing, withering and drooping of leaves, and also the younger leaves turn yellow in color. The new plants produced are become smaller, yellow and do not unfold properly. Soft rot occurs with burst smell. More often, the spindle is blown up when there is a heavy wind, leaving the capitated stem. Bleeding patches is seen near the base of the stem. It goes up to 3 to 5 meter height. We can see the bruiting body or sporocrop produced along the sides of the basal stem. Flower development is also arrested. Button sheds and bunches hang down. Nuts are barren. Color quality is poor. Water content and copra weight, oil content are decreased. Roots are discolored and severely rotted. So these are the symptoms of basal stem rot. So as we already the yellowing and drooping of leaves and also bleeding patches on the lower surface. So we can see the decapitated stem and also bark beetle also favors the incidence of disease in this formation of bracket. So these disease can be managed through integrated practices. So it's cultural practices like removal, destruction of severely affected dead forms. Irrigation should be restricted from the infected form to healthy forms by forming isolation trenches around the infected form. So intercropping with banana reduces the severity of disease. Application of 50 kg of formian manure per form per year. Growing of intercrops like Desmodium, Calopeconium, Thertusia purpurea, Protonaria, Curcuma or reduce the severity of disease. So coming to the biological control, application of Bacillus subtilis and Trichoderma vidi at the rate of 100 gram each per pound per year along with neem cake was found to be more effective in reducing the disease. Application of Bacillus subtilis DNA mixture and 50 kg of and 50 grams of Trichoderma vidi along with 10 kg of formian manure is also recommended for once in 6 months. It is soil drenching of 1% Bodo mixture at the rate of 40 liters per pound, and also root peeling with hexaconazole at the rate of 2 ml 100 ml of water is recommended thrice at 3 months interval. Root peeling with propiconazole at the rate of 2 ml 100 ml of water at quarterly interval also found to be effective. Stem bleeding, this is caused by Theophyllus paradoxa or Cetosis paradoxa. Here we can see the exudation of reddish brown liquid from the cracks of the stem, and these exudates dries up and forming black crest. This infection reduces the vigor of the tree and nut yield is also reduced. The tree is not killed uprightly, but it becomes uneconomical to maintain. So mechanical injuries should be avoided. The drainage should be improved. Irrigation should be given during summer months. The infected portions should be removed, and you should be pasted with the powder paste or copper oxychloride paste or Trichoderma vidi paste. So the severely infected forms should be removed and destroyed. The exposed surface should be painted with the hard coal tar, and also cavity should be filled with cement. Basin irrigation of each form done separately. So application of formian manure at the rate of 50 grams along with 5 kg of neem cake is also recommended. Application of Bacillus subtilis mixture DNA or 50 grams of Pseudomonas and 50 grams of Trichoderma vidi along with 10 kg of formian manure per form at once in 6 months interval. Root feeding with hexaconazole at the rate of 2 ml 100 ml of water for thrice at 3 months interval is also recommended for managing this stem bleeding disease. So coming to the leaf blight disease, this is caused by Lassi diploria theobromae. This disease is prevalent in Coimbatore, Tiruppur, Dindigul, in coconut growing regions. Compared to these Coimbatore, Dindigul and Tiruppur, this disease is incidence is quite low in other southern districts like Tirunelveli and Kanyakumari. So the disease infects all types of forms. 15 years old forms are susceptible and the age old forms are more highly susceptible. This disease causes yield loss up to 10%. This disease is more severe during summer months. So the affected forms, the leaf shows drying tip downwards and exhibit charred or burned up appearance. Dark grey or brown lesions with the wavy undulated margins appear from the apex of the nuts. So the affected nuts were desiccated, shrunken, deformed and dropped prematurely. So we can see the reduction in vigor of the seedling by lesser leaf production, shunted growth and poor nut yield in adult forms. So these are the symptoms of leaf blight on leafless trees, fronds as well as on the nuts. So this disease can be managed by removal and burning of severely infected leaves. So and also spraying of Bodo mixture 0.25% or copper oxychloride is recommended. Root feeding with cordondistin 2 gram or hexaconazole 2 ml plus 100 ml of water 3 times in 3 minutes release also recommended. Application of 200 grams as pseudomonas process along with 50 kg of formulated menus will take care of disease. And also neem cake should be applied at the rate of 5 kg per pound per year. So application of additional quantity of potash over above a normal recommendation. Coming to the clave leaf spot caused by Fritz-Lochia palmarum. This disease is mostly prevalent in young palm compared to older palm. So we can see the symptoms in the palm of grayish white spots with dark brown margins surrounded by yellow halo. Many spots coalesces to form necrotic patches. So leads to the complete drying and swelling of leaf blade, giving burned up or blighted appearance. A large number of acerulae seen on the upper surface of the leaves. So these are the symptoms of grey leaf spot. So this disease can be managed by removing and burning the severely infected fronds, and also drainage conditions should be improved. Additional quantity of potash in addition to 3 kg per palm is recommended. So application of pseudomonas process at the rate of 200 gram along 50 kg of decomposed formulated menu is also recommended. Neem cake should be applied at the rate of 5 kg. Spraying of copper oxychloride 0.25% or bodomche 1% is also recommended. Root feeding with carbendazim 2 gram and hexaconazole 2 ml in 100 ml of water 3 times in 3 months interval is also recommended for managing this disease. So rootlet disease or Kerala disease. This disease was first reported in Kottayam district of Kerala during 1882. This disease causes seed loss from 35% to 80%. So the important symptoms are the infected leaf shows flaccidity, that is abnormal curving. It is resembling like ribs of mammals. So yellowing of leaves and marginal necrosis of the leaflets. So from the infected trees, we can see the shedding of patterns, and also the size of the nuts get reduced. The ground size also get reduced. In advanced stage of infection, the tree remain unproductive. The infection shows necrosis, rotting of roots, and also leaf rot symptoms also appear. So these are all the symptoms of root flaccidity, yellowing of leaves, and marginal necrosis, and also infection, necrosis, rotting of roots, and leaf rot symptoms. So this disease is mainly transmitted through plant copper, known as Protista maestra, and Strepanitis typicus, known as lacewing bug. So disease can be managed by cutting and removing the palms which are yielding 10 nuts per year, and these the varieties like Malayan green dwarf and CGD and CGD into WCT are tolerant to this disease. And also application of balanced dose of fertilizers, that is urea 1.3 kg, superphosphate 2 kg, muriate of potash 3.1 kg, plus 1 kg of magnesium sulfate, which is organic, meaning 50 kg, along with 100 grams of pseudomonas fluorescens and neem cake is recommended. Mulching the basin with the coconut leaves, and also growing of green manure crops like cowpea, sunum, grotularia, calopeponium, buraria. It should be sown in the coconut basin and incorporated during September, October, and also proper irrigation should be provided during summer months. And also growing inter and mixed crops like banana, pepper, cocoa, vanilla, turmeric, pineapple, coffee and nutmeg will provide additional income in addition to controlling the disease. So spraying of dimethylate at the rate of 2 ml per liter of water is recommended along with sandalwood, which take care of the vectors of this rootlet disease. So coming to the leaf rot disease. So leaf rot disease occur along with the rootlet disease. So this is caused by more than one fungal pathogen, so this fungal complex known as Phototrichum gliosporiodes, Extrohylum rostratum, Filarium species. Here we can see the water shock lesion, brown color lesion in the leaves, and also gradually these spots enlarges and coalesces, resulting in extensive rotting. So as the it affects the unfurling of leaves, and also sometimes symptoms become very acute and the sphere fails to unfurl. So the disease can be managed by pouring fungicide solution like hexaconazole 2 ml or mangosteen 3 gram in condensed milk water, and also spraying should be given with 1% boric mixture on 5.5% copper oxychloride or 0.4% mangosteen during January, April and September. When spraying, ash has to be taken to spray on the spindle leaf.